NFL 22 on EA Sports. And today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Chargers and the Eagles coming up next.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as the Eagles will match up with the Los Angeles Chargers. As always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all. We'll see him call his own number here as well.
On first down, Watson. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down. Sanders, first carry of the game. And good pursuit yet again by the Chargers as they stuff him behind the line. It'll go down as a two-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. From the gun, here's Watson. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They'll run. It's Sanders. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. The numbers for Sanders last week, 21 carries, 52 yards and a touchdown.
And give him a ton of credit. He's running the ball really well. But I look at those guys up front. That unit is truly playing as just that. Every move that they make, their teammate understands what that move means and what they need to do. And right now, they're starting to grind it out pretty well.
And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Well, this defense for the Chargers, they were strong last week, CD, and that went over New England.
Well, we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard?
And he fires one, it's intercepted. Picked off by the rookie, Asante Samuel. And they start with great field position at the 41-yard line. After the turnover, here's Herbert. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Gather not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch.
And he's going to go down. It's Kerrigan getting the sack. I think that time he just maybe held on to it a little too long, CD, because after a couple of seconds in this league, you know those defenders are coming.
And how many times do we talk about complementary football? We usually talk about, does the offense help the defense? Does the defense help the offense? I think in this case, does the quarterback help out his offensive line? You only have a certain amount of time to get rid of the football. They can only do so much. On this play, he took him to the limits.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that play.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Kick is good, and the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchdown.
Let's go!
Deshaun Watson and his offense heading back out there. He'll look to shake off the interception on the opening drive. He should at least be comforted that it resulted in 3-6.
And if I were him, I would be the guy all the way out on the field greeting my defense now, saying, thanks a lot. You held him to a field goal after I turned it over. That's a big defensive stand for them. He needs to go out now and make up for what he did on the first drive.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down. Second down at 7. Watson. Throw over the middle, caught by Jordan. And able to get this one across the 45. It's brought down.
And that's an unacceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Now a throw here to his running back. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Let's go! Let's go!
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Second and 10. Running right, here's Sanders. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming. Off of play action, it's Watson. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Goddard. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump up and hold on. And wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Watson flush to his right. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear, and it
Knicks.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a... Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know, a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs, you know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get it. This was an offense that wasn't just talking about the notion of ball control. They were preaching it. They wanted to win the time of possession battle, and they've done.
And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. His ninth touchdown of the season, and the Eagles have taken the lead. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. And this is no good. He missed it. Got a good start here in the kicking department as this remains a 6-3 score. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Here's the all-pro returner from 28. Now a hit and a loose football.
Let's go.
So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secure. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 20 carries, 106 yardage-wise, and the score as well.
And the way they ran the ball last week's game has to be satisfying to their entire staff, because they're seeing not just a back gain big yardage, but they're seeing an offensive line really in sync.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Herbert has it knocked free, but a Chargers player was able to keep possession.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Receiver coaches pressure guys all the time. Separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Jared Cook. And some room to run now. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A big gain that time for the Chargers. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Eckler. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Touchdown, LA! Donald Brown, his first touchdown on the year. And the Chargers are going to retake the lead. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that will make this a 4-point game. 10-6 the score after one right here on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CB, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here, because to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. The Chargers able to get the pressure and bring it down.
Kenneth Murray in there to get him. It's a loss of 5. Going to need something special here on 3rd and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? Steps away. He'll have a first down past the 40. And gets it across the 50 and down to the 48.
Let's go. Under the category of obvious, you hate giving up a first down, a 3rd and long. And somehow, he finds his way downfield and picks it up.
Yeah, if you look at the coverage defensively, this is great, but no one accounted for him at the quarterback spot.
At some point, you actually have to tackle him and get him on the ground short of the first down marker.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now Watson, rolling to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down. Out of the gun, Watson. He'll buy some time right. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to 3rd down. The Eagles on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. D4, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. The kick by Elliott is good. And that gets him back within a single point. It's now 10-9. Also a career kick for the veteran Chase. Touchback as that sails over the end line. Austin Eckler in the Charger offense reclaims center stage. Those are his numbers through roughly the first half of the season, and given that, you'd have to think he's on pace for a 1,000-yard campaign.
Steady as he goes, steady goes the offense. But you know what else is happening, too, because they are a team now recognized with the ability to run the football. You've got to be able to throw better now, right? Better throwing lanes, better opportunities for the guys downfield, maybe more one-on-one coverage, which you should be able to beat easier. Yeah, he's establishing not just a tone, but an identity for his team.
And that's a discussion we had a couple days ago in the team meetings, talking about this running game opening up the passing game. We'll see if that continues to happen. Running on 1st down, Eckler. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Now, after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 47. We'll check on his status when we get back. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Herbert. Nowhere to go for Herbert. And he's got it. Closing 10 on the sack. And it'll lead to a 3rd and 0. Out of the gun, Herbert. Going deep here for Allen. And this is great. Falls incomplete. Hunter Nyswander on to punt now on 4th down. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost have to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board. We'll see. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But third down coming up. On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets in the enemy territory.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
They'll roll him out right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I think it was a big adjustment, but much more emphasis on making sure they knew where he was when he decided to take off with them.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Sanders. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Eluding the pressure away. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside Detroit.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can. And that's what he's done very well in this game.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw, escaping the pressure right. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. To throw is Watson. And his throw here is going to be incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there, picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22.
Get him, boy.
Ochenna Nwosu coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it also brings up 4th. That's number 4. Sack number 4. They had 4 last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Gardner, they said the eye in the sky does not lie. And that's indeed the case because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now this defense will be searching for sack number 5. The Charger drive about to get going. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. This is swung out to Eckler. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Good one, boy. Let's go. Let's go.
And they'll use him out in the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. So, Charles, if you talk about this offense as we play here in week 9 of the 2021 season, normally you're slipping kind of past the halfway point, but now with the season expanding to 17 games, you kind of think the teams might look up and say, gosh, we still have a lot of football left to go.
No doubt about it. Remember, they've had their open week already, so this could be a straight shot all the way from here on out. To me, the best coaches, they tell their teams, hey, I'll take care of you during the week. You just leave it all out there on game day, and I'll make sure you're ready for the next one.
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Now a throw in the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Herbert now. side here. It's Allen. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. And the Chargers get a signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. To the air again, Herbert. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to roll him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete. Certainly one they'd like to have back as it breaks up fourth down. The third down, he tried to stay in bounds. Did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too close.
That's always difficult.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
He's trying to stay behind. But the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. Was the bottom half that was in question.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They have a good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket. No reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. From just shy of midfield, Watson flushed out right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Throw across his body, and it's intercepted. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. Throw he probably shouldn't have made, rolling left and then throwing back across the field.
And when you do that and you're rolling towards the sideline, you cut down your field in a big way, significantly. And the guys who play in the second and third level, those linebackers and DBs, they know that. And they know they have nearly...
Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line.
Let's go.
And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Touchdown! That's caught. Mike Williams, as the first half is winding down, and the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead is up to 8. Pretty clean and simple there, just 2 plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. Taken from about the 12. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Final shot before the break. Watson looking here for Smith downfield. And this is caught inside the 5. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line.
Yeah.
So we have reached halftime. Intermission with the visiting Chargers on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman ready with our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
Okay, all right, Brandon, thank you very much. Hi again, everyone. Let's get you caught up with what's going on around the NFL as we are officially into the second half of the season. We'll start over in Texas at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, where you see the final score there. Dak Prescott leading the way again as his guys run their mark to 8-1. From there, we head over to the West Coast. Check out the Niners at home at Levi's Stadium. And they've got the lead over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. The 49ers looking to sew that one up, and they look to be in pretty good shape. Lastly, let's get you to MetLife Stadium to see what's happening with the Giants at home in East Rutherford. And things didn't go so well, as it was the visiting Raiders who come in and grab the victory. Derek Carr, excellent in the victory, as it's one that pushes his guys two games above 500. With that, we take a look at the next-gen stats in that first half for the Chargers. And their passing game has been the reason why they lead thus far. They've had great success moving the ball through two quarters of play. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, they too were able to take advantage of a soft secondary, as both of these two teams really threw the ball at will in that first half. Both these teams making their final halftime adjustments. We're just about ready to get back to football. So for the call of the second half, we get back up to Philadelphia and Brandon Gunn.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Andre Roberts now to return it. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. So here are the Chargers to take over. They defeated the Patriots last week, now looking to make it two in a row here as they come up first and 10. They started on the ground with Eckler, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Credit the tackle to Darius Slay. Second and five now. Herbert. Roberts got it. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Herbert on first down now. And his throw here is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10, here's Herbert once more. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 26. Draw play, it's Eckler, down to the 25. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Under pressure and down he goes. The second back at the 36. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. Here's Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. And he'll be stopped here. Short the first down at the 24-yard line. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down. And Hopkins' kick is good. And that will bump the lead up to 11. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get it out of the end zone.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. It's caught by Sanders.
same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And looking for a lane, but none to be found for Sanders as they stop him short of the line to gain.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run.
And now on fourth and one, it's a fake. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool this defense. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. On first and 10, Herbert. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Roberts. Four yards remain for second down. Back to throw here, Herbert. He'll drop this one off to Eckler. 2 yards on the pickup there, and that'll bring up a third down. Here's Herbert. And this is Cook with a grab. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
That's it, baby!
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven at the 20-yard line.
Side complete. That's Williams. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. On first down, it's Herbert. And he's gonna go down. He's sailed back to the 24. Well, looks like a loss of right around 11 there on first down to set him back on second. To try again after the sack. Herbert. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they're going to drop him well short of the first as he can only make it to the 11. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. The Chargers will bring out the field goal unit now. Hopkins' kick is good, and that will get the lead up to 14. The second field goal here this third quarter, and his third of the game so far.
He's been an important part of the offense, that's for sure, and they may need him again before this one's said and done. So I would treat him like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter. Leave him alone and let him focus.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. On first down, Watson. He finds his man, complete. It's Jordan. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Now it's Watson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. Now Watson. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. The former third-round pick, Justin Jones, bringing the lumber that time. Gonna need something special here on third and long after that sack. What does Watson have in his arsenal? Going deep here for Watkins. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. On is the punt team now as this one sent away. The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line.
Let's go!
36 yards on the punt, but no return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, I think you take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that
feel. Right there on the brink, aren't they?
It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. He dumps it to Eckler underneath. That's a room to maneuver. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup on the first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or take away. Otherwise, this will probably get away from them.
Throwing again on second and 10. Herbert. Nowhere to go for Herbert, and he's going to go down. Javon Hargrave, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's into the hands of Eckler. And to the 46, he goes and no further. So he is well short of the first down marker. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long. On is the Chargers punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This will be fielded at the 17. Now it appears we're going to get whistles and stop a man down on the return. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Looking to throw again on second down. Watson, he's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. The Eagles on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This is third and 11. Goes to the sideline and incomplete. Nearly intercepted, in fact. But he couldn't hang on. Fourth down. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Call that 49 yards on the punt. They do get 7 back on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Austin Eckler and the Charger offense reclaim center stage. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this at the 41-yard line. The Chargers on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. They need just a yard here. It's third and 1. Once more, here's Eckler. And Eckler will not get there. Great defense at the point of attack. Going to stop him short of the first down. the Chargers punter now as he's on to kick it away. This is taken at the 23. That'll go as a punt of 44 yards that time. And the Eagles will have it taking over first and 10. Watson now to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Jordan. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. Here's second and 10. To throw is Watson. He finds his man complete. That's Jordan. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. From the gun, here's Watson. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. To the air yet again, Watson. But it's caught on the right side, it's Smith. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
From the 39-yard line, here comes second down at six. Back to throw, Watson. Left side here to Sanders. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
Well, so they had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Watson. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Smith. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of seven. Working with a second and three. Out of the gun, Watson. That's caught by Jackson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Sliding out of the pocket. And not able to get it that time. He hit on six straight passes. Not there, second down. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play. Third and goal, being chased out left. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the six here on fourth and goal. Rolling to his right. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Deshaun Watson taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Eagles have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
The defense was almost too good on that play. They took away all of his targets. The one thing they forgot to account for him as a runner. And he's able to tuck it and go for the end zone and get it done.
This time he gets it to go as it is up and good. That one in the books has a drive, play, drive. And the final back ball to Deshaun Watson. It is his touchdown run.
The 15. It's first and 10.
After the interception, here's Watson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbound because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again as he'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Gonna need something special here on third and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's gonna wind up incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
So an interesting call there to take the three, and I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but that might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The attention shifts back to Justin Herbert and the Chargers offense. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. Let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him. It did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
On second down, Eckler. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but it works.
Yeah, exactly right, but the problem for them is still within possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They have to find a way to throw effectively as well.
He's airing it out for Williams. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. Big gainer in his sights, but he did not reel it in. On is the Chargers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. Now here come the offense as they take over. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes.
Here we go.
A one-score game.
Here we go.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Oh, fighting off the defender. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and that'll be second down. Watson trying to get his guys moving. Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Watson to throw. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. And this one is incomplete.
formation on first down. Trying to go back to Watkins. Here's Watson, but it'll be second down. They'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Steps away to his left. Finding room to the 20. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to build the fly line, level at everything he does, and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Watson gonna sneak it. Yeah, he's across for a touchdown. Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for the Chargers, the struggle